हेलो माय स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू माय टुडेज टॉपिक। टुडे आवर टॉपिक इज सर्कल, दैट इज चैप्टर नंबर 10। ओके, सो यू मे हैव कम अक्रॉस मेनी ऑब्जेक्ट्स इन योर डेली लाइफ व्हिच आर राउंड इन शेप। ओके, सच एज व्हील्स ऑफ ए व्हीकल, बैंगल्स, डायल्स ऑफ मेनी क्लॉक्स, कॉइन्स ऑफ डिनोमिनेशंस लाइक रुपीज 1, रुपीज 5, 50 पैसा। ओके, so in a clock you might have observed that the seconds hand goes around the dial of the clock rapidly, okay, and its tip moves in a round path, okay, so that the round path traced by the tip of the seconds hand is called a circle, okay, like that. So this traced path is known as the circle. Okay, so all these are the examples here of circle. Okay, so in this chapter we'll study about circles and other related terms and some properties of circle. Okay, so at first we'll learn about the circles and its related terms. Okay, so we are taking a compass and fix a pencil in it. Okay, put its pointed leg on the point on a sheet of a paper. Open the other leg to some distance, keeping the pointed leg on the same point. Rotate the other leg through the revolution. Okay, now you'll see that a closed figure already made up. So this figure is known as the circle. Okay, so here is the figure. Okay, so the collection of all points in a plane which are at a fixed distance from the fixed point in the plane is called a circle. Okay, so here A is the fixed point. Okay, got it? Okay, the fixed point is called here the center of the circle. So here the point A is known as the center of the circle. Okay, and the fixed distance is called the radius of the circle. Okay, got it? So here O is the center and OP is the radius here. Okay, so the fixed point is called the center of the circle and fixed distance is called the radius of the circle. So here the distance between the center and any point on the curve or this figure will be the same. So all these distances will be the same. Okay, and all these are known as the radius of the circle. Okay, so the line segment joining the center and any point on the circle is known as the radius of the circle. Okay, so that is, radius is used in two senses, in the sense of a line segment and also in the sense of its length. Okay, so already we are familiar with some of the following concepts. We are just recalling them. Okay, so basically a circle divides the plane on which it lies into three parts. Okay, number one is inside the circle, that is interior part. Okay, the circle, this is the circle, the figure, and the outside part of the circle, which is known as the exterior part of the circle. Okay, so the circle and its interior makes up the circular region. Okay, so if we take two points, that is P and Q on the circle, then the line segment PQ is called a chord of the circle. Okay, so here is PQ is a chord of the circle. Okay, the chord which passes through the center of the circle is called a diameter of the circle. Okay, so here is the chord which is passes through the which is passing through the center of the circle. So it is known as the diameter. Okay. So as in case of radius, the word diameter is also used in two senses. That is, as a line segment and also as its length. Okay. So now the question is, do you find any other chord of the circle longer than a diameter? The answer will be obviously no. Okay, so we see that a diameter is the longest chord and all diameters have the same length, okay, which is equal to 2 times the radius. Okay, so we know that diameter is equal to 2 times of radius. Okay, got it? Okay. So here in this picture, figure number 10.5, AOB is a diameter of the circle. Okay. So here is the diameter of the circle AOB and PQ is the chord. So also you know that AB is the longest chord that is passing through the center. Okay. Got it? Okay. Now we'll talk about the arc. So a piece of a circle between two points is called an arc. That is ARC, arc. Okay. So a piece of a circle between two points is known as the arc. So now look at the pieces of the circle between two points. Here we are taking two points on the circle. One is P, another one is Q. On figure number 10.7, we will find that there are two pieces, one longer and other smaller. Okay, look at the figure very carefully. Look at the figure very carefully. So here is the arc that is longer and here is the smaller arc. Okay, so the longer arc is known as the major arc and the shorter one is known as the minor arc. Okay, got it? Okay, so the longer one is known as the major arc, that is PQ, and the shorter one is called the minor arc, that is PQ. So the minor arc PQ is denoted by PQ and the arc sign, and the major arc PQ by PRQ, by PRQ in this view is known as the PRQ and then the sign of arc. Okay, so here R is some point in between P and Q. Okay, so unless otherwise stated, arc PQ or PQ arc stands for minor arc PQ. Okay, so when P and Q are ends of a diameter, then both arcs are equal and each is called a semicircle. Okay, when P and Q are ends of a diameter, then both arcs are equal and each is called semicircle. Okay, got it? So semicircle means, if I take this figure and this is known semicircle. Okay, so here P and Q should be here, P and Q. Okay, so P and Q are ends of a diameter. Okay, so here is the diameter that passing through the center. Then it divides the circle in two parts. Okay, these parts are known as the semicircle. Okay, got it? Here both arc are equal. In this arc is equal to this arc. then it is called known as the semicircle. Okay. Now, the circumference, the length of a complete circle is known as the circumference. Okay. So, the length means this portion is known as the circumference. Okay. Now, the region between a chord and it and either of its arc is called a segment of the circular region, or simply you can say that a segment of the circle. Okay. Got it? So, we will find that there are two types of segments, which are the major segment and the minor segment. So, look at the figure number 10.8. Okay. The region between an arc and two radii joining the center to the end points of the arc is called a sector. Got it? Okay. So, at first we have to recall again the segments. So, we will have two types of segment. One is major segment and another one is minor segment. So, the what is segment? The region between a chord and either of its arc, okay, is known as the segment of the circle. Okay, so if PQ is the chord, so this segment is known as the major segment, where major portion of region is covered, that is major segment, and it is known as the minor segment, where the less region is covered by the chord PQ. It is the minor segment. Okay, got it? Now the sector. What is sector? The region between an arc and, look at this figure very carefully, the region between an arc and two radii. Okay, here we will have two radius. One is OP, another one is OQ. Okay, so here we are having two radii. So the region between an arc and two radii, so if we think about this arc, that is PQ, and we are taking two radii, that is OP and OQ, then this is known as the sector. Okay, and also it is the sector. Got it? So when covering major portion of a circle, then this sector is known as major sector. And when the sector covered by the two radii and arc is less, then it is known as the minor sector. Okay, got it? It is the minor sector. Okay, so got that the knowledge? Okay, so now in this figure 10.9, the region OPQ, this OPQ is the minor sector. Here it is minor sector, and remaining part of the circle region, which is greater, is known as the major sector. Okay. When two arcs are equal, that is each is a semicircle, then both segments and both sectors become the same, and each is known as a semicircular region. Okay, so when the radius is like that way, OP and OQ, then these two sectors will be the same, then we can say that we will having semicircle with same sector. Okay. Now the next part is angle subtended by a chord at a point. So at first take a line segment, that is PQ. Here you are taking line segment PQ, and a point R you are taking, not on the line containing PQ. Okay, now join PR and QR like figure number 10.10. then angle PRQ, this angle is known as the angle subtended by the line segment PQ at point R. Okay. Now we will be looking for the theorem 10.1. The theorem 10.1 tells us that equal chords of a circle subtend equal angles at the center, and here is the figure. Okay, so already we are given that two equal chords of a circle subtend equal angles. Okay, so we can say that the chord AB and CD of a circle, here is the center, that is O. Okay, so we want to prove that angle AOB, that is angle AOB, is equal to angle COD. Okay, so if we prove that triangle AOB is congruent to triangle COD, then obviously we can say that angle AOB equal to angle COD. Okay, so in this figure, that means in triangles AOB and COD, OA and OC are the radii of a circle. Okay, so we can say that OA is equal to OC because these are the radius of the circle. Then again, OB and OC are the radii of a circle. So we can say that OB is equal to OC again. And in the question, given that equal chords of circle. Okay, so we are having two equal chords here. One is AB chord, another one CD chord. So we can say that AB is equal to CV given. So therefore, you can obviously write that triangle AOB is congruent to triangle COD. Okay, got it? So once we have proved that these two triangles are incongruent, so obviously we can say that by CPCT rule, okay, corresponding parts of congruent triangle, that is angle AOB, is equal to angle COD. Okay. Now theorem 10.2. So theorem 10.2 tells us that if angles subtended by the chords of a circle at the center are equal, then the chords are equal. Okay, so this theorem is the converse of the theorem 10.1. okay, so already we are given that a circle with center O, okay, AB and CD are the chords that subtend to the equal angles at center, that is angle AOB is equal to angles DOC or COD. Okay, now we have to prove that AB equal to CD, that the chords of this circle are equal. Okay, so in triangle AOB and COD, look at very carefully in this figure. Okay, in this figure, in triangle AOD and COD, OA equal to OD radius, okay, and angle AOB is equal to angle DOC, already given, and obviously OB equal to OC because these are the radii of the circle. Okay, got it? So we are having OA equal to OD, radius of the circle, OB equal to OC, radius of the circle, equal, and already given that angle AOB equal to angle COD or DOC. So obviously you can say that these two triangles are incongruent, okay, by SAS congruence rule. So obviously by CPCT we can say that AB chord is equal to CD chord. Okay, got it? Next, that is theorem 10.3. So 10.3 theorem tells us that The perpendicular from the center of a circle to a chord bisects the chord. Okay. So here, given that C is a circle with center O. Okay. Now, here AB is the chord. Okay. Such that OX perpendicular to AB. Okay. Now, we have to prove that OX, this perpendicular, bisects the chord AB. That means we have to prove that AX equal to BX. Okay. So, in these two triangles, that is OAX and OBX, we are having angle OXA, this angle, and OXB, this angles is equal because OX perpendicular to AB, so both are 90 degree. Now OA equal to OB, radius of the circle equal, and here OX is common in both of the triangle, so obviously you can say that triangle OAX and OXB are in congruent by RHS rule. Okay, so by CPCT rule, we can obviously write that AX equal to BX. AX equal to BX. So we can say that the perpendicular from the center of a circle to a chord bisects the chord. Okay. Go to the next. Now it is the theorem 10.4. Now 10.4, the theorem tells us that the line drawn through the center of a circle to bisect a chord is perpendicular to the chord. Okay, got it? So here, given that a circle with center at O, and here AB is a chord of this circle, and OX bisects AB, that is AX equal to BX. Okay. So we have to prove that OX perpendicular to AB. Okay. Now we are taking two triangles. One is OAX and another one is OXB. Okay. So here in this triangle, circle OA equal to OB, radius of the circle, OX is common to both of the triangle, and AX equal to BX given already. So by SSS rule, AOX, triangle AOX is congruent to triangle BOX. Okay, so if we prove that triangle AOX is congruent to triangle BOX, then obviously by CPCT rule we can say that angle AXO is equal to angle BXO. Okay, got it? So we can say that OX perpendicular to AB. Okay. Theorem 10.5 tells us that there is one and only one circle passing through the three given non-collinear points. Okay. Next theorem 10.6 that tells us equal chords of a circle or of congruent circles are equidistant from the center or centers. And 10.7 tells us that chords equidistant from the center of a circle are equal in length. Okay. So, in the next lesson, we'll learn all of the rest theorems and examples. Okay. Thank you.